that good.
And who better to know how you want it to be evolved and molded than you? You're the one that's creating this.
Hopefully, and it allows me to write songs and like really fast. So this is going to be like our last official like full length. We're going to be doing singles from now on. And at the end of, like, I don't know, whenever I feel like it's right, we're just going to compile them and put them on a record as, like, a full length.
Oh, but, that sounds awesome.
But it's more, like, hot off the press because, like, I'll write a song and then I have to sit on the song for months and I lose the passion for it. And I want to be able to go on the internet and be like, we just wrote this song. It's fucking killer. I'm so stoked on it. Have some cool art with it and, you know, make it a thing, maybe do a split. Who knows? There's just so many things that you could do. I want to have an interactive experience with the people that are out there that follow the band. So make it real close and personal, do collectible items for them, things that are, you're not going to be able to just go get. Like, it's going to be like, I put it out and if you don't jump on it that day,
it's gone.
Yeah.
Like the old days.
Yeah, kind of. And it's just...
limited release.
It just seems fun. And then, like I said, at the end of the year, you compile it onto one thing, and that's there forever.
Oh, that's cool.
Right? You know, that's the kind of the plan. It might seem far-fetched. I know there's some other bands, I can't say which bands, but there's some other bands that are going to be doing this. And I think it's going to be kind of the wave of what will be expected in the music industry, because rock and roll has taken a little bit of a side seat to like rap and stuff. And those people, when you look at what they do, they're putting out these singles, these rap videos, doing all this stuff. They're making it fun for everybody. And I feel like that might be what, I don't know, it's just me personally, I feel like that might be what's lacking.
Right.
Is there's not people's attention spans have changed because social media. We're constantly seeing new things. We're constantly buying things. We're constantly consuming things. And I'd rather them be consuming music.
Yeah. Not only that, but it also is a great way to bring back that old school pleasure of hunting.
Sure.
Especially since... you know, that discovery of finding new music in record stores was almost extinct. Now it's kind of crawling back, but still.
It might still become extinct because it's getting harder for any of them to survive, because, like, we've seen, like, huge record stores close. Tower Records, Warehouse, Sam Goody, these places we grew up going to and buying things from, gone. See you later. Blockbuster, gone, just by Redbox. Now there's Netflix, Amazon Prime, Hulu, on and on. There's so many services for these things. And, you know, a lot of the record stores, I think, were surviving off Blu-rays and DVDs for a while, to be honest with you, because it wasn't as, you know, like, that was a big seller, because CDs have kind of, you know, died off. Vinyl's kind of making this comeback. So it's like...
But
cassettes, and that's weird. It's a weird one for me. Everybody's going to start... They're going to need to buy boom boxes and start bringing them out to the parking lot. I haven't seen it yet. I'm waiting. I'm waiting for the boom box.
You know what? Don't be surprised, man. I mean, I can almost picture...
probably were doing that.
Of course, dude. I still have a cassette player.
I know you do.
I still rock my old cassettes, even though, you know, sometimes I think they're going to break while I'm playing
them. Yeah, that's the thing, you know, like, I don't think everybody's prepared. Like, I was thinking about, like, something that would be fun with the cassette that I personally did growing up. You know, we could do, like, a hot pencil. Because you have to put it in there after your car stereo eats your tape. You're like,
yeah, right?
Fuck, it comes out in this, like... It's just the guts and intestines are hanging out.
Taking me back to those horrific days.
And you're like,
man. And
this pencil, you could do it. You could wind it way faster. I was like, they're going to need that if they're going to actually be listening. I think it's still more of a collectible thing than actual an audiophile thing right now.
Yeah.
It might, like, but the thing is, with some of the hi-fi boom boxes with EQs and graphic EQs and nice preamps, you're going to get a good sound from tape. But if you don't have that, you know,
yeah.
You remember what a Walkman sounded like? Oh.
Yeah, right. I still have that too, man. You're dating me here. You mentioned that you're recording with new artists that you're finding. Have you you know, you're from Fresno. I think everybody knows that. Are you finding yourself finding helping out local bands from your area?
There's none.
Really? Still?
Still.
Wow.
Yeah. There's a lot of, like, I'm not that into death metal and those kinds of musics, and that seems to be what's more prevalent in Fresno, and I'm just not there. Do you feel me?
Yeah.
Because, like, I'm not really, like the bands that are coming, like, I'm not, like, charging them an arm and leg. I'm making it easy for them.
Yeah.
You feel me? And for me to have to sit and listen to somebody screaming at me, not saying that that stuff's bad or anything, but if somebody's going to scream at me all fucking day, I'm going to have to tax them.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you want to record something that's going to be innovative and fresh and at the same time something that's going
to
vibe with
you. I'm very busy too, and it's more, it's like, seriously, I have to really like the bands. Like, I love Fortress.
Yeah.
As you can see, I'm rocking it tonight, and I really want to see those guys evolve.
After you play tonight you're playing with Lucifer.
Yeah.
Are you going to Europe?
Yeah.
Talk to me about that.
Going in October 31st, Halloween, playing with Angel Witch.
Sorry. Nice.
And Night Demon. And that's going to be, it'll kick off the European tour. We're going to be doing the rest of the shows with Screamer. Some of the shows will have Tanith, which is Russ Tippin from Satan's new project. They just put out a full length on Metal Blade. It's killer. So that's going to be really fun. I'm sorry, but geographically, I'm just like, right now, I don't know exactly. All I know, a lot of Germany, some Austria, and some Switzerland. That's all I can tell you.
Nice.
I wouldn't even know where to begin to name the clubs.
Yeah, well, I mean, right now you're engulfed in, you know, feeding the baby and changing the diaper. That right there takes a lot out of the, you know, the agenda.
Well, I mean, try to memorize German club names. You know, when you just look at it, when you glance at it, you're like, all right, there. I just go, there's the date. I have to be there, and I'm just going to try to. That's it. Even here in the States, I do the same thing.
Yeah.
I just look at the date. I'm like, we're playing here that day. That's it.
The new record, when will it be out?
January 3rd, 2020.
What's the title?
Mind Freeze.
What label?
Shadow Kingdom Records.
That's the same label that has the other releases, correct?
Yeah, yeah. I've done all the Haunt releases have been with him.
Okay.
In conjunction with Church Recordings on a couple of them, like Luminous Eyes, Mosaic Vision, the EPs, I've kind of kept the tight leash on it because I do want to be completely independent and DIY. That's huge for me. It's a big motivation for me musically to be DIY. So trying to do it all myself, man.
Awesome, man. Trevor. Always a pleasure talking to you.
Brother.
Let me congratulate you on the birth of your son.
Thank you.
You're a very blessed man. You're a very hardworking musician. And as you heard it, new music coming out from Haunt.
That's right.
Go get it.
Thank
With
you,
that,
guys.
We're out.